In this video, guys, we're going to look at trailing stops, a quick guide. Stay tuned. Hey traders, warm welcome to you. Thank you for joining me. All right, so trailing stops are a super useful, can be a super useful tool to add to your trading strategies, your trading plan, to your trading arsenal. Now, a trailing stop effectively means that you're trailing your stop loss up as price moves in your direction. So if you're long, price is moving to highs, your trailing stop is going to come up with it. And a traditional trailing stop with a platform, you might put in a trailing stop of, let's say, a trailing USD JPY, swing trading it, it might have a 50 pip stop, 100 pip stop, day trading 20 pip stop. Regardless of the time frame you're trading, you can employ this tactic. So as the price goes in your favor, the stop will move up. If price starts coming back off the highs, that stop doesn't move, only moves again once the price breaks to new highs and it moves higher. So finally, when it comes back, it's going to stop you out. So you're locking in gains. Now, the issue you have with trailing stops is if you have it too tight, you get stopped out very quickly on a little bit of noise. You can imagine if it's really, really tight, it rallies up, comes back, stops you out, and then a bigger move happens. If it's too wide, then you're not locking any gains. The price can go massively in your favor and come all the way back and stop you out. So it's a real art form to try to determine the parameters for the stop. But there's other ways of doing it. Rather than just thinking in terms of, okay, how do I put the width of the stop? There's other ways of doing it which aren't so binary, i.e. on or off. So a couple of ways to think about this, guys. Let's imagine, if we can for the moment, that you're long a stock or a market or currency pair, whatever it may be. Let's say you bought this little breakout here and the market started to chug up, and your thesis is that if the market broke this low, you want to be out. So that's your initial thesis and trade idea. Long here, stop below the low, and you think, hey, it's going to push to highs. Now, when you're implementing a trailing stop, the idea of that is that you don't necessarily have a fixed target, because if you've got a fixed target, you're just doing a trade that goes from point A to point B, and that's a different type of trade. You're saying, okay, I think it's going to go from here to, you know, let's say here, and that would be where your target is. When it hits it, you're exiting the trade. Differences with a trailing stop is that you're saying, hey, I don't know where this is going to go. I don't really have a final target for it. Or if I do, maybe the final target's up here, but after a certain point, I'm going to trail. So you have to think about when to trail. In my experience, and again, this is just the way that I like to do it, I don't like to trail a stop early on, because I feel there's kind of three phases to a trade. You've got the initial higher risk phase, where you've literally gone in and you've got full risk on the table. It's just full risk, because if the trade goes against you immediately, that's your full loss. And then you've got what's called the cruise. I call it the cruise. It's kind of I like to use the analogy of a flying a plane. You've got the takeoff, reasonably risky. If things go wrong there, you haven't got much time to sort them out. When you're in the cruise, if you get an engine failure up there, you've got time, and most of the time, depending on what aircraft you're in, where you are, the terrain and stuff, you're probably going to be okay. We're going to be much better off anyway than you are at takeoff. And then the landing as well. You get the landing wrong, things can go bad. So, rough analogy, but you get the idea. So when a trader, I consider this kind of vulnerable part at the beginning. So at the beginning, I wouldn't want to trail a stop, because I don't really want to move my stop until I feel like I'm out of the danger zone, if that makes sense. So let's say we get the move and then we start to push up to highs. Now, am I going to trail it there? Probably not. So my first thing is when to trail. I might say, okay, I will trail once we get a move in my direction, a pullback, and then a continuation. Again, entirely up to you, this, guys, but it's kind of thinking through the process. So for me, I might start to then trail if we kind of break out up this level, because this would probably be an entry for me long anyway if I wasn't taking it down here. So I might start to activate my trail at this point. So the reasoning being, I've broken out from my high, I've pulled back, and now I've broken out from that pullback, and I believe now that it shouldn't come back down. I think it's probably safe to be able to trail a stop. Now, of course, you've got a couple of options here. You either don't do anything with your stop and think it's not quite gone in your direction, fine, or you manually bring it up, which many people will do, or you start to employ a trail. Now, a trail at this point is to say, okay, how will I trail the stop up? And you've got a couple of ways of doing this. So let's say you get to the position now and you go, right, I'm now activating a trailing stop technique. It was fixed. I feel like I'm out of the danger zone. I feel like risk has been reduced. I feel like trade is starting to go my way. How am I now going to implement a trailing stop? A couple of ways of doing it. First one is manual. So this is where you just literally go, right, I'm going to bring my stop up every time we break to a new high, for example. Some specific binary rule that says, hey, I'm going to move my stop. So let's say go to a new high, you might then ratchet it up by 50 pips. $2, whatever asset you're trading, pull it up, again, moves to a new high, moves to a new high, etc. Now, that's fine, but the danger you have with that is, you know, let's say it moves to new high and fakes out a little bit. Sometimes you can be tightening things back up. And that might be what you want to do. Depends on the asset you're trading as well. Assets behave very, very differently. Are you in a really trending environment? Are you in a momentum ignition explosion environment? Are you in a mean reversion environment? You've got to take this into account. So the other one which I quite like is a time or day-based stop, which gives you time to think about what's going on, and gives you a little bit of control, if you like, rather than just being a binary event. And I like to have a little bit more control of stuff. I like to have a set of rules, but I also like to give myself a little bit of flexibility to allow my trader's intuition and my experience to be have a little bit of flavor, a little bit of input into the trade. So you might say to yourself, right, if you're day-based, you might say, okay, at the end of the day, I can bring my stop up, I can move my stop once per day. So it's a manual trail. So in other words, hey, we had a really strong day today, I wouldn't want to see it below the low of today. So in which case, you might bring the stop. So example, if this was a, let's say that was a day's worth of trade, you might say, wow, it was a good breakout day, and let's say a 60 minute chart, I'm gonna bring my stop under this low here. So that'd be a manual thing. The next day you'd review it and go, oh, we pull back a little bit. So if you're day trading, then again, you would just look at it at a specific time in the day. So let's say every 15 minutes or every hour or whatever it may be. So it's a specific time, point in time where you then assess the price action and make a decision based on the price action you've seen and whether you want to move it or not. So there's a bit of flexibility there. Okay, now we get some more fixed stuff. So fixed stuff is, right, when do I trail it? So we talked about that. I prefer to have some point in time when I trail it. And then we go, right, maybe I have a fixed stop. So in other words, then you can employ the kind of fixed 50 pip trailer or 100 pip trailer, which literally just goes, as it goes to a new high, it's coming up, it never goes lower, and it's just pushing up with price. And that's fine if it's something that you say, okay, and a good example of this might be, right, well, I've scaled out some of the position, I've taken off half the position, I feel now that whatever is left is just a bonus, I've got my stop in, I'm gonna put a 50 pip trailer, 100 pip trailer, whatever it may be, I'm prepared to give back that amount, and if I get a multi-day run out of it, then fantastic. And the width of that trailer makes sense to be at a sensible position. So you don't want it so tight. So the way you do this is you look at kind of the rotation sizes and go, right, well, from there to there was 80 pips, from there to there was 75 pips. So 100 pips would make sense if you just kind of, you know, push it onto the chart. There's no point having a 20 pip trailer when the last three pullbacks have been 80 pips and 70 pips, because you know you're going to get stopped out. Of course, if that's what you want to be able to sit through some of these bigger ones. So again, never black and white, but you get the idea that the stop should be wide enough to accommodate another pullback, a backfill before an extension off, because the last thing you really want, and I know you can't always start preventing against this, but last thing you want is to be trailing up here, getting stopped out, and then you're actually leaving the biggest final push of move because you've already been stopped out. And then there's indicator based, guys. So very, very simple one to do is a trailing based stop on a moving average. I'm a big fan of this under certain conditions. I've talked about this in videos before. Many of you guys like that kind of video where we talk about, hey, if we are ripping with a five period moving average, a real momentum type trade on a daily with a five pressing right up against price, then using that as a guide and saying, hey, if we close below it, I'm out, keeps you in trades for a long time, much longer than you expect, and it's such a useful tool. Or you might go a little bit wider, depending on what the type of conditions. Again, conditions really do dictate how tight you go with the stop. You know, if price is winding up and down like this, a five pier is gonna be running right in the middle and you're just gonna get pinged out. Maybe a 20 is more of a useful stop for that. So again, adjust it and tweak it. So manual is something you look at, and adjust based on a new high or a new low or whatever the price action may be. Time or day basis, you change it a specific day and time and ratchet the thing up. Now proper, I guess you could say these are true trading stops, is we use a fixed stop or an indicator based stop and they just run up with the market and it literally goes and goes and goes. And I've talked about that. Another indicator based stop you could do rather than just a moving average is something like, you know, an oscillator. So this would be a little bit of a, this would kind of be a little bit of a hybrid type strategy. So you could say, let's imagine we have an oscillator down here, good old stochastic, let's use that. Let's say once it's gone overbought, it's here, or an RSI or CCR, you might say, hey, as soon as it comes off overbought, I'm going to close the position. So that's a nice way of staying with that extension without overstaying your welcome. That's quite tight, but you might want that. And again, let's just rewind a little bit. It's not always so binary, guys. Sometimes you might want to tighten that stop right up. Let's say it's coming up to a price level that's really close to your target. You might then go, right, well, I'm not going to give 100 pips now. I'm going to give it 50. I'm going to give it 20. I'm not going to use a 20 pip move now. I'm going to use a 5. I'm not going to be, you know, you start to real turn the screw on it to tighten things up because you don't want to give more back. So again, it's not so fixed in a binary event of a trailing stop or not. Start at the beginning, we've got no trailing stop, then we might have a wider trailing stop, then we might tighten the thing right up as we're getting towards either our price target or what we believe is going to be the natural extension of the market anyway. Might be a 3-day move if you're kind of a 2 or 3 day swing trader. Might be the end of the quarter, something that you think, hey, maybe this is the end of it, but if there's more, I'll take it if the trailing stop allows me to, but if there isn't, I don't mind coming out of it. So going back to the oscillator, RSI, CCI, stochastic, you know, as that starts to come off overbought, you might close it from there. So that's a bit of a hybrid way of doing it, but not a bad strategy because the markets can stay overbought. And if you're in it, it's sometimes a real shame to get rid of it. And then we've kind of jumped the gun a bit, but number three, guys, is how and when to adjust. Again, that's personal preference, but I like to, as I say, tighten things up when I feel that we've had a big move already. So maybe, you know, we've had one, you know, two, and we're on drive three. And I know that from the feel of the market, or I have an idea from them, we never know, guys, this thing could just go straight in a straight line for the next 10 days. Markets do what they want to do. But let's say we know the rhythm of the market is a 1-2-3 day wave type environment. You know, when we're kind of double topping up here, that might be the signal to go, right, we'll tighten that thing right up. You know, we're not far off our target here. Won't want to give much back from this. Let me adjust the trailing stop and maybe bring it up to, you know, above that second low. Or maybe I'm going to trail it on a moving average. Or maybe I'm going to use the stochastic or whatever it may be. You get the idea. So, you know, thinking about trailing stops in terms of, right, where's the most risk? When do I want to lock stuff in? And don't fall into the trap of just having it as tight as possible, because that's tempting. You know, I don't want to give anything back. But if you do that, you're never going to be in the big trades, because the big trades, very rarely, you know, very rarely do you get a trade where you go long and it just goes bang. Happens from time to time. When it does, you go, thanks very much. You put the money in your bank and you go, I put money in a trading account and you go, great, next trade. Of course, it's going to happen. As same as it's going to stop you out straight away. You trade enough trades, that's going to happen. But majority of the time, guys, it's not going to happen like that. You have to kind of think, right, it's going to go in my direction a bit, come back, come this, come back. And a trailing stop also might help with the psychology of the fixed stop mindset of, oh, I don't want to give it all back. You know, so if you're planning this beforehand, again, with all trades, I really like pre-planning and thinking about the scenarios. And inevitably, guys, when I make a mistake and I make an error, it's when I haven't thought about and I've done things on the fly. Let's say a trade's gone massively in my direction. I've thought, great, it's as good as going to go and hit my price target, really high price target. And then it's pulled back hugely again. And I've gone, oh, you know, should I have taken some off the table there? Because I hadn't planned for it, I hadn't thought about it. Then I end up taking a little bit and then it goes again and you end up being in a little bit of a mess and a muddle. So if you're always planning what the scenario is, how you will trail it, what will happen if the market goes, because at the end of the day, you know, it could go all the way up here and then come all the way back down here and you've taken that ride. And that's fine if you are prepared for that and you don't want to have a trailer. That's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. You can say, right, well, I was looking for a much bigger move. I didn't get it. It would have been nice, but hey, I was looking for a bigger move. I was prepared to trade this environment, etc. But you may want to allow for that and say, hey, I don't want that to happen. I want to lock in always 50% of what I've made or whatever. And so if you've pre-planned it, it makes life a lot easier. Anyway, guys, that's trailing stop losses. A quick guide. Let me know your thoughts, on the, as always, in the comment section below, how you trail. If you've got a sneaky little tactic that you'd like to share, how you trail your winners, how you kind of really adjust these things, or you know, do you even trail at all? I'm interested to hear your opinions and thoughts, guys. We've got a good group of traders out there. While you're down there, guys, check out our channel sponsor. There's a link to them in the description below. As always, take care, keep risk managed, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye for now.